हेलो गाइस, टुडे आई विल ट्राई टू डू वन मोर एक्सेल वीडियो एंड इन दिस आई विल ट्राई टू से एक्सप्लेन अबाउट कैलकुलेटिंग लोन्स एंड हाउ मच एक्सपेंसेस यू आर गोइंग टू गेट रिगार्डिंग दैट इन एक्सेल। सो दिस विल बी गुड फॉर मेंटेनिंग योर ओन यू कैन से रिकॉर्ड फॉर हाउ मच पेमेंट्स यू नीड टू मेक एंड हाउ मच मनी यू नीड टू कीप अवेलेबल एंड वी विल ऑल्सो जस्ट सी EMI calculation in Excel along with a calculation of principal and interest amount in the EMI. So let's start. Let's see how this video goes. If you want more such videos, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and leave a like if you find this interesting. So let's start. So first, if you are going to find a new house, the first step that you should do certainly find a agent, and through him then you will get to go to many different localities, find out the home you like. If you can shortlist the home, then you negotiate the price. And after that, many people only know up till this. And one more thing is your stamp duty and registration receipt after that. But and then there will be some more expenses that you have to go through. So here let's see, I have made a trial Excel based on this itself and we'll see. So unhide this, I have already updated everything. So now first thing is booking amount that you do, and that is approximately, I guess, about 1 lakh should be the okay price in the current market conditions. This part you see, next is how much funds you have on your own. This will be whatever amounts in your bank, mutual fund, share market that you are going to invest into the new flat or new home that you are going to buy. Next will be this amount. So the 1 crore 75 lakh amount is what is the seller's price. So there will be many amounts extra that are not included in this amount. This is what you have to give to the seller himself, and all other amounts will be derived from this. So as a result, your booking amount and your own funds are what you are going to have to arrange yourself. This amount is the seller's amount. So the difference between them should be what should be considered as your principal loan amount that you are going to have to avail. One more thing is, this amount is exclusive of all these amounts. So when you are deciding how much funds you can use, you first have to take all these amounts into consideration before you find out the loan amount. Hence, if suppose all these things you did not know up till now, so we'll hide all the things. You only know that 1 lakh you have to give. You will be able to arrange suppose say 1 crore 6 lakhs, and your total amount to pay is 1 crore 75 lakhs. So this is a normal calculation that you have done. So this 1 lakh amount is exclusive, so we'll just keep it like that. If you want, you can always put this as this minus this itself. In this case, I have not done. If you want to do, you can do that. This is normal, just add a cell, subtract a cell, however you want. However, we should remember that this is not the only expenditure. The 1,76,000, this is not what you are going to pay. You have to pay all these things along with that, and this amount itself is, see, you can see coming close to 9 lakh rupees. This includes your lawyer fees. You will need to draft the sale agreement or deed for sale or whatever document you are going to make. Agent fee is generally 1% of the seller's price. Stamp duty, this is 3%. Or was 3%. I think this rate changes currently as we I am recording. I think this is 5% now. But I think till March or somewhere it was 3% itself. So this plus this is registration charges, and these are all other minor charges. Like you have to do all payments to all the agents. Even you should understand, if you are taking a loan, there is a 0.3% on the loan too. So if this amount increases, even your stamp duty on the loan amount will increase. This has to be paid for registration of your loan document. And then miscellaneous payments, loan transfer, I think some 25,000 was there, 12,500 per member, अपना 12,500 for the seller and 12,500 for the buyer. Many banks also insist upon taking insurance for the new property that you are buying. So whether they insist or not insist, miscellaneous expenses do happen. So this amount itself will be 9 lakhs total. So as a result, you can see that if this amount, consider all this amount, you will see that your loan amount will be going to increase. In actual terms, you have to consider, suppose approximately 1 crore 85 lakhs, and subtract whatever own funds you are going to arrange. So in this case, it will be 1 crore 7 lakhs. You see, if it's here, you go to here, comma style, click comma style here. So this is views much properly. I think there is a separator commas for lakhs, crores, as in Indian terms, or in, if you are using a US term, it will come in millions. Some other time, I will show you how you convert this comma style from lakhs and crores to millions. And so this will be what you are looking at, the original loan amount. So you can see that it has increased by 9 lakhs. So there we go. So after this, we will see EMI calculation in Excel. Now there are many EMI calculators available on the net. If you directly go to any bank site, EMI calculator is mentioned prominently in the loan section. But doing it yourself in Excel is, you can say, it is a good way of understanding Excel. It is a good way of understanding what all variables are included in your EMI. And if you want to make any changes, and if you want to compare different, you can say, bank rates or different proposals that you have got, then making your own Excel sheet and is a much, much more, you can say, helpful for comparison purpose and all these purposes. So let's see. So this is your formula first. So first we'll be looking through this formula, then we'll go through this formula. So this is your normal EMI formula. This is actual mathematical formula. This is Excel utility or Excel formula, you can say, where you do not understand what is going on in the background. So this is your actual EMI calculator. We have got P, that is principal amount, R, that is your rate, N, that is your period. Now here we should understand that R is not the normal rate, like 7%, 8% that you see, but it is actually per month rate. So if it's 12%, it will be 12 by 12, that is 1%. This N is the number of months. Generally, you will be given a period in years. So number of years multiplied by 12 will give you the small n that is used in the formula. So here we'll see. So here is the particular, all the differential that you will require to fit in the formula. This is the notation used, and this is the amount. So now I am going to give an example of the 69 lakhs amount of loan that I had included in this example. Whatever you have, you can just try it out first, check with my 69 lakh, or you can check on the net and you can reconfirm whether your formula is correct. So principal amount is 69 lakhs. Interest rate is 6.74%. Let's hope it decreases further. That will decrease my EMIs also. Interest per month is, as you can see, percentage divided by 12. So 6.74% divided by 12 will give you the capital R that is used in the formula. N is the number of years. So generally it will be 20 years, 25 years, 30 years if you are planning to take a home. Less than that will be rare, I guess. 20 to 30 years or some period in between is best one, or at least that's the one which taken the most. This is, as you can say, पीरियड इन मंथ्स दैट इज 12 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई पीरियड इन ईयर्स. नाउ आफ्टर दिस दिस इज हाउ आई ऑलवेज मेक माई फॉर्मूलाज. नाउ इफ यू सी, इफ यू लुक हियर एंड लुक हियर, ऑल द थिंग्स दैट यू रिक्वायर आर गिवन. यू कैन मेक ए फॉर्मूला डायरेक्टली. सो जस्ट फॉर सेक ऑफ यू कैन से शोइंग वाई इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू डू लाइक दिस, यू से इज इक्वल टू. सो नाउ दिस इज 69 लैक्स इज पी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय कैपिटल आर दैट इज दिस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय अगेन ब्रैकेट ओपन 1 प्लस कैपिटल आर अगेन C4 ब्रैकेट्स क्लोज raised to that is shift and 6, so you will get the raised to symbol, raised to small n that is raised to 300. Now here this bracket is closed, so now you can see this and this have been highlighted. So this multiplication bracket we have closed after C6, so the bracket that was opened after asterisk after C4 is getting closed here, and then divided by brackets open 1 minus another bracket open 1 plus r bracket close raised to again capital small n and again bracket closed, and you will find that it highlights the bracket before one between division sign and 1 and enter. So you can see that this formula and this formula will give the same result. However, making this formula is prone to mistakes. If even if there is one bracket somewhere here and there, your whole formula will change. At least it will show the error and you can never be sure. So this method is much better. You say 1 plus r, you break this formula into different, you can say, groups. So p is individual, r is individual, no issues. 1 plus r, take it, n calculated, 1 minus 1 plus r, calculate it, formula calculation will become much easier. So you get 1 plus r, simple enough. 1 plus r raised to n, still simple enough. And 1 minus 1 plus r raised to n, simple. You directly use this formula. This is complex. This is very easy. You can always use this. And as you can see, just multiplying this divided by this will give you the answer. So now this is coming in minus and negative. In reality, if you just put a negative sign somewhere over here like this, it will become a positive answer if you want to use it somewhere else. So this is how you calculate EMI in Excel directly. You can make your own EMI calculator in Excel. Now you see, if you just copy this, control C, go below, put enter here. Anything if you want, you say you want a loan of not 69 lakh but 75 lakh. So 7500000. Suppose you are not getting a 6.74, suppose you are getting a 6.80% rate, 6.80. So you can see this is taking correctly. There you go. Some issues with my Excel. 25, say you are want to take it for 30 years. Say you want to take for 30 years. You can see the EMI will decrease. This is 360. I think 30 years will be the maximum. This has changed. This has changed. This has changed. And your EMI has changed itself. Just to cross check where it will always be correct, but if you want, you say 6900000, 6.7425, answer will again come back to this. So while you are doing control C, control V, you can see that the full formula itself is getting copied, and as a result, if you want it horizontal, if you want it vertical, you can make 3-4 comparisons if you want, for different banks, different principal amounts, different interest rate, different period. Like if you suppose you want to take 69 lakh, but say you can pay more than 47,629 per year, you try for 20, yeah, it becomes 52. So if you are sure that you can use 52, you can go for a 20 year formula. If say you don't want 47, you want less than that, you go at 30 and see it becomes 44. So you can, this is much more easier to use than the actual going to the site and you cannot compare it side by side. You may have to write down the EMI, maybe some other things you want to calculate with this. This is much easier doing here. So next, yes, as you can see, I have used the unfreeze freeze panes thing. If you go here, I will unfreeze the unfreeze panes. So you see, if you go down, this will be going away. If you want to use freeze panes, go here, view freeze panes, freeze. See, this dark blue will be where our cell is selected. If you want to freeze it from here, you keep your in D3 freeze panes. So you will see that this will be freezed and this will be frozen here. So this will continue to, this may be used somewhere. Good to know how to freeze and unfreeze panes. Right now I just need the first column, so there you go. So after this, next we'll be just using the Excel formulas that are directly provided. So this is there unhide here. Yeah, so these things require, Excel requires four. That is monthly interest rate, period in months, you can say principal loan amount, and month for which calculation. So the month for which you want to calculate what is the principal component of the EMI or what is the interest component of the EMI. So why not we'll do one more. Let's see, we'll, this is what I have done according to original calculation. We'll make a new and see whether it gets correct here. So suppose principal loan amount is 75 lakhs. Interest rate will be, let's say, 7%. We'll go with 7%. N is 30, let's say N is 20. So for EMI, this is the one, PMT. So we'll go is equal to PMT. So see, EPM calculates payment for a loan based on constant payments and constant interest rates. So calculate the payment is actual, calculate the EMI. So open the bracket, rate. So this rate will be rate per month. So that will come to this, comma. Net period is the total period for which the loan is to be taken. So this will be 240, comes here. Present value will be the principal amount. So that will be this. FV type, you'll keep it blank, not currently usable. So let's see what we'll get. So you see this and this comes equal. This is coming in red because it's negative. If you want, say you keep, cancel this minus, it will come minus here itself. Principal loan amount, you put a negative sign here. So this has come positive and also this has come positive. So next will be the principal and interest. Suppose you want to calculate the principal for the, I don't know, let's say for comparison purpose, for the, let's do two comparisons. One will be for the, again some issues, month, yeah, MONTH. So one will do for the fifth month, and the second we will do out of the 240, we'll do for the 230th month. Let's see. So what will be the principal and what will be the interest rate? So this will be 5, this will be 230. This will be easier to calculate. So is equal to, you see the formula is PPMT. So PPMT brackets open. Rate will be again the rate per month. This period is the period for which you wish to calculate, so it will be the 5th, comma net length, that is 240, net period length, and again comma 75 lakhs. So this will be, and say just you can, instead of typing everything, you can just copy this below, and in place of P, you just make this as I. So this addition you will see will match with 58,147. Now as you can see, principal and interest is heavily skewed in the favor of interest. At the 230th month, it will be exactly opposite. It will be skewed in favor of principal amount. So again, this will be same. We'll copy this here. Instead of phi, that is what is phi is k20. We need l20. So that is only difference. So in place of k, we will make it as l. And similarly over here, instead of k20, we will make it as l20. So you can see that though EMI is same, your principal amount and your basic amount and your interest amount are in heavily different places. So thanks for watching. If you want to make your own calculator in Excel, I can always say that it is better to do this instead of going always to your bank site or on the net. And this helps in making Excel. This will help you in getting used to Excel, using different formulas and how to use them. So thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Thanks a lot.